7.
Hello everyone, this is Data Driven Chat, and today I'm very happy to introduce Shivam Bansal, who is a practitioner. He's a senior data scientist at H2O.ai. A very exciting person. He's on many watch lists for data scientists, so I'm really excited to have him here today with us. Hi, Shivam.
Hello. Thanks, Kana. Thanks for introducing. It's a pleasure to talk to you and share my experiences.
Thank you so much. So, Shivam, can you tell me, how did you become interested in natural language processing and applied data science?
I'm currently working as a senior data scientist at H2, as you mentioned. But I have more than 6 years of industrial experience in different domains like insurance, banking, healthcare, finance, etc. And most of this experience is into applied data science, natural language processing, etc., in which I have helped different customers, different clients in building production level data science solution for many different problems. So coming to your question, which is one of the very interesting question and important for personally for me as well. During my undergraduate studies, I was doing computer science and engineering. And at that time, I was more into computer science, web application development, software development, etc. But just out of curiosity, in my last semester of my course, I took a different course, which was, of course, text mining and natural language processing. And I became very interested in doing all the assignments and all the projects. And coincidentally, my first job, I also started working as an NLP engineer, in which I worked on a lot of unstructured data. So I realized that a lot of value can be obtained by working on unstructured data, and NLP was the core skill which was required to work with such data. And over the years, eventually I grew more interest in that area because I also started getting feedback directly from different people, different customers, different clients, that what they are getting from things like NLP, data science, is very valuable to their business. So I kept motivating myself to learn more, to compete more on different channels, etc. And that's how my journey with NLP and data science started.
Well, that's awesome. So you essentially came from kind of engineering background. This is exactly my experience as well, because I was an economist and then eventually I got a job in engineering department. And that's how, you know, my journey in data science started as well. So that's awesome. Tell me, if you had to pick one most important thing that you achieved during your career, what would it be? So what are you most proud of?
Yeah, so I will definitely be most proud of my Kaggle experiences. I was into data science since past 5 or 6 years, but I started working on Kaggle late in starting of 2018. And I started sharing my contributions. I started participating in some competitions. I won a couple of them. I won 3 Data Science for Good challenges, in which the company selected my solution as the best one, and I was also awarded. And on top of that, I became Kaggle Grandmaster in a matter of 8 months, which was the highest at that point of time. And that was the biggest achievement, I would say, that is highlight of my career so far.
Awesome. Yeah, I'm very impressed. 3 Kaggle competitions, that's a lot. That's awesome. Someone who works in data science, can you give some tips to people who want to get into the field? What is the most important thing to remember if you want to be a data scientist in your view?
Yeah, I think the most important thing is that once you have decided to become a data scientist or start the data science journey, it is very important to remain dedicated, because nowadays on internet, on online and offline, there is a flood of information. There are so many courses, there are so many mentors which one can follow, and it is very easy to get diverted in that process of learning. So personally, I have realized that whatever you start, whatever you pick, it is very important to complete it without avoiding any distractions, because sometimes it might happen that we started a course, but we lost interest in the midway, and we suddenly just close that course and we suddenly move on to something else. Or maybe someone else suggested that, hey, this course is not good, maybe you try something else. So you keep on jumping. And this wastes a lot of time. So data science is a big field. Data science involves a lot of concepts. And that's where I think it's very important to become very dedicated in that learning process. And the data science journey is about trying different ideas and failing in them, because that's how you keep on learning new concepts. So another tip is to open to ideas, open to fail, open to experiment, and keep on trying. And that's how I always call this skill as structured thinking, like, because it's a big field and there are so many things to try and we need to avoid distractions. It's always important to be very clear in what you want to do. Maybe we break down our learning process into different tasks and then take action on them. And this is the same skill, structured thinking, which we have to apply during the data science projects as well, during the real industry projects as well, because the problems can be very complex and we have to again apply structured thinking to break down into smaller problems and then follow the solutions as such.
Can you tell me, you just touched on industrial projects. So if we look at data science for business, why is data science particularly important for business? And in your opinion, how did data science change consumer journeys over the last few years? Was there a big difference before the data science came in and after, do you think?
Yeah, so I think it's a very important question. And there are a couple of things. One thing is there is a data landscape in which every day a lot of data is being generated, but not a lot of value is being derived from that data. And parallelly, there is a very competitive landscape as well, in which a lot of technology is evolving and a lot of people are doing very cool work, very smart work. And to be competitive in businesses, it is important to get an edge over your competitors. And that's where data science is particularly important. What the companies, organizations can achieve with their business knowledge or domain knowledge will always be lesser than what people can also achieve with data science. Like, if we augment that information of businesses and their domain knowledge with the data-driven practices, with the data science, they can improve a lot in terms of consumer journeys, in terms of improving the business metrics, such as maybe cutting down the cost, maybe improving the revenues of the company, improving the profits, in terms of customers, making them more happy, customer retention, customer happiness. So all those things which makes the organization evolve and improve over time requires a taste of data science. And that's what the trend I have also seen in the past few years, that earlier people used to rely more on their rules, more on their ethics, and slightly less on data-driven practices. But with data science into picture and with a lot of data available, if they apply that techniques in the right manner at the right time, they can get a lot of advantage in terms of different verticals, which definitely improves their business.
So some of the people who will listen to this podcast today are not actually very technical. So what I was wondering is, how important is the ability to code? Yeah. Do you think it's an important skill to have, or can you still get into data science even if you are, I don't know, a history major? And related to that, I wanted to ask you, what is the best way to develop the skill? Is it to better learn by doing, or to take courses, or maybe you can recommend what to start with? Should people learn a particular language, or should they do something else first, something like algorithmic thinking tasks, those types of things? Yes.
Yeah. So yeah, again, another important question for any data science enthusiast. First of all, I think to become a data scientist or data science as a field, we can in fact categorize it into multiple personas. Some can be pure computer science or machine learning engineers who are very close to the coding part and they have to implement data science part as well. And some other personas can be more into research or more into analysts. In those roles, they might be doing less code, but they might be using some tools. They might be researching about the business or solutions, etc. So in industry, when we talk about real use cases, we need these different personas. We need engineers who can implement, as well as we need domain scientists who can analyze something, who can provide some insights, etc. Now, having said that, personally, I feel that ability to code is very important because I have also seen this in my journey that I have learned a lot by doing rather than reading a book or doing a course, because that's where when you write a code, you actually see how whatever you have learned, how it actually works. What are the things are changed when you apply some different codes, when you change some parameters, etc. What are the different results that you get? And most importantly, in industry, when we work on real use cases, things are not pretty straightforward that you can just use a tool and it will give you an output. You need a lot of customization. Sometimes data needs to be cleaned. Sometimes machine learning models needs to be customized. Sometimes dashboards needs to be created, which are tailored to the business. And that's where I believe the ability to code is very helpful, because if you know such skills, then you can quickly deliver those prototypes and solutions, and you start getting the output or the feedback very quickly. As compared to, let's say, we are waiting for a tool or a software, and like we are improving the software just to get the results. So that may take a lot of time. So that's why, personally, definitely, I think ability to code is important. And the other part of the question that you asked, like how people can develop this ability, is of course by taking the first step. Like as I mentioned in my previous question, that there is a lot of information out there, and one of the information is Kaggle, of course, in which users can share their code and what we can do, and the beginners can do. They can start referencing that code and write their own course. They can write their own data science projects. Let's say they have learned any new concept in any course, they can go back to home and then recreate that whole concept by actually applying. So that's where I think doing some activity on Kaggle and or maybe doing some activity on GitHub are some of the ways in which users can improve their coding skills.
Awesome. So I'm so glad you said that, because I keep telling my students that, you know, I can stand here preaching about Python and R and GitHub and all this, and you can listen to me for hours and hours, but you will not learn much. You need to find an interesting problem and try to solve it. That's
correct.
So I'm glad
what you can provide them a right direction. You can give them a quick start. But the next journey is something which the students have to do by themselves, by recreating, by repeating what they have learned in the form of code, in the form of applied data science part.
Awesome. Obviously, I mean, we live in a very, very strange time right now. A time to be alive, right? And we cannot avoid the conversation about COVID-19. So, in your view, NLP and data science more generally, can it help in the current crisis? And in what way? Can you see some applications of the skills that you have in the current environment? Yep. Where do you think data science will have most impact and so in this crisis?
Yeah. In the COVID-19 situation, data science has a very important role. And in fact, many of the data scientists, which includes researchers, my fellow Kagglers, many other organizations are using data science and NLP and some of the techniques to solve this problem in different parts. In fact, in my current company as well, in H2O.ai, we are working on building an application which can help hospitals to forecast the incoming patient flow so that they can prepare better themselves. When we talk about NLP, I think one of the areas where NLP can help is to do the text mining very comprehensive on the past researcher papers. These type of viruses have came across many times in the past history, and many a times researchers did their research. They maybe produced a successful vaccine, etc. Maybe NLP can be applied to those research papers, and maybe we can find some interesting patterns which can help us to develop a unique vaccine for COVID-19. That's where NLP will play a lot of role. Other areas can be if we start using those forecasting models, simulating models in which we can help these hospitals, help the government to prepare the resources, to prepare the staff, to prepare the doctors, to prepare the force needed to overcome this situation and to handle this situation. So these type of applications, if government and hospitals have, so they can preemptively focus on what is likely to come, and maybe the number of casualties or number of people who are getting infected, that can be reduced or that can be lowered down with such areas.
So you mentioned obviously a lot of possibilities for data science and NLP to contribute to the solutions for COVID, which will probably be a major task in the next few years. Can you think of priorities for data science in the next 5 years in consumer behavior to basically help businesses? Because the other part of the crisis is the business part, right? So a lot of business right. Currently in distress. So do you see a particular role for data science in helping them outlive this crisis?
Yeah. So data science is currently, and of course, will also be playing a very, very relevant and important role in almost every field, in almost every type of businesses in the coming years. So as I mentioned before, like, data is everywhere and it keeps on increasing. And most of this data is unstructured. Like, as of now we are speaking, so we are generating the data. And so are the customers of different companies. And now to win in that competitive landscape and to improve the businesses, to get the more consumer behavior relevant for the organization, data science is very important. And if you talk about, let's say, some of the key areas which will play a lot of role, is of course the one is natural language processing, because as I mentioned, NLP is the skill set which will help to deal with this unstructured data. The second piece of information is applied data science, again, which involves that we will come up across the situation in which we have to quickly apply data science practices and get the results. So that's where I think data science will be important. The third area which my company also works in is automated machine learning. So nowadays, not just, let's say, engineers and researchers are there. Even the business people also want to quickly apply data science into their business organization to get a glimpse of consumer behavior or to understand their customers or to solve any business problem. So that's where, instead of reaching out to a team of, say, a big data science team and giving them a full-fledged big project, they will probably use automated data science solutions in which they will put up the data and get the results and then start taking the decisions quickly. These are some of the key areas which will be important. And of course, our things like forecasting, computer vision, optimization, operations research, these type of things will also be there. These type of things will also evolve rapidly and will be very important.
That sounds really exciting. I don't know whether you can share this with us, but maybe you can talk about what you are currently working on and what are you particularly excited about? Maybe you can give an example of a project that you're particularly excited
about. Yeah, sure.
What keeps you awake at night so you really cannot
turn
this thing off?
Sure. So in my current company, I'm working on building different applications which are helpful for businesses, like, as I mentioned, that sometimes business people want to use AI or data science, but they don't have the right skills. So what I'm doing is I'm building these type of applications which they can install on their mobile, they can use it from their iPad or laptop. They'll start asking some questions and it will give you the intelligent answers. You can plug in different data and it will then try to learn from the data and try to improve the evaluation metric or the business metrics. So this is more like automation of AI using AI. For example, doing BI, business intelligence, using AI, like instead of using tools like Tableau, Click, where we have to create a lot of charts manually, what the users will do is they will put in their data and it will give you all the interesting questions as well as their answers, which are data driven. And automatically the models, machine learning models, will also be trained and they can also get the answer. So I'm working for this type of generic applications, and this will be applicable to different industries like finance and insurance and healthcare.
Yeah, so there's a lot of potential there.
Yes. So another part of your question was what keeps me awake at the night. So one of the thing that I have always followed in my journey is that I always try to create the data science solution which are polished, which are relevant for businesses, which are end-to-end, which do not just focus on the one part, but rather focus on the complete aspects of the problem. So that's where I try to put a more effort into whatever I have done by making it more impactful, making it more relevant and meaningful for the end user. And that's, again, I think it's a very important skill for data science and any data science enthusiast, that they have to have an end-to-end thinking. One should not focus on only just, say, modeling part or on the NLP part, but what will be the aftermath, how these models will improve the businesses, or how you will reach to this stage where you can actually train the models as such. So if you think more end-to-end, you can create more meaningful and more impactful solutions.
Yeah, really, the possibilities are endless there. So thank you very much for sharing this. So now we will come to the last question. And this is a traditional question that I ask everyone. Okay. So if you had to pick one book and one film that you could recommend to people, what would they be? Okay. And you can only pick one of each. That's the only restriction.
Got it. So if only I have to pick one film and a book, so I would say The Imitation Game is one of my favorite movie, and that's every must watch for every data science enthusiast. And in terms of book, I have read plenty of books. I have many favorites, but again, if I have to just mention one, I think it will be Introduction to Statistical Learning. That's the foundation of many statistics and many machine learning NLP concepts. So that's one is a must read book, according to me.
Awesome. Thank you so much, Shivam. Thank you for finding the time today to talk to me. Really appreciate it.
Yes, thank you. Thank you so much. It was a pleasure sharing all my experiences.
Thank you.